right, the 2020 season likely to unfold, especially early on, with few or no fans in the stands. More and more teams announcing that they will begin the season without fans. The Patriots yesterday, no fans. Now the Chiefs are going to try to have 22,000, I think, or 22% capacity, which is going to be less than 22,000. The Cowboys are going to do it, but for the most part, there aren't going to be fans. So today's draft, inspired by the reality that Mitchell Trubisky would probably be better off playing without fans present, especially in Chicago, where they've given up on him. The people who should be the happiest about games without fans. Trivia question for you, Chris. Which stadium in the NFL currently has the lowest seating capacity?
Wow, the lowest seating capacity. Hold on, I'm just going to look at the teams here. Wow, whoa, I was not expecting this type of... I'm going to go with the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Incorrect. Chicago Bears, 61,500. Man. Soldier Field. You know what? Can you believe it? But you know what? We were there last year. They took out all those seats when they redid it, and there's this giant wall of suites.
Yeah.
Like, I guess I can understand why there's only 61,500 seats.
You're right. I feel like this came up at one point last year, and I should have remembered that because, yeah, it's a big stadium, too. You wouldn't think of that being in there. One of my favorites. It really is. It might be my favorite stadium in football. That setting, downtown, Chicago, the old structure of the old stadium, and then the inside of the new stadium looks like a spaceship, and it's right on top of the field. It's really cool. I like it. All right, go ahead with your first pick, you jerk.
All right, I got the first pick, and I had a point of clarification last night as we were debating what the draft would be. It's the people who should be happy that there are no fans, and I'm going to steal the point that you eloquently made within the past couple of weeks about how the officials in basketball are performing without fans there to give them the business. I'm going with the NFL officials. The people in black and white stripes, their life is going to be a hell of a lot easier without fans there to try to influence the outcome, yell and scream, complain about everything, complain about the bad calls, complain about the good calls, just shout insults every time they try to leave the field. You're never going to have any friends when you're in that uniform of an NFL official, and those folks have to be thrilled. Maybe that's why so few of them opted out. A season without fans?
Yeah, I'll take
sign
it.
Me up for that.
Man.
I'll take it.
I can't believe
so that's
it.
Mine.
I'm shocked. I thought I was going to be able to pick that as my first pick because that is, that was going to be it. I mean, Mike, I know you're not like a huge NBA basketball fan, but I really do recommend you just tuning in for a few minutes to see how the game's different. It's totally changed. The referees are not flustered. And because there's no fans and you can hear more, I think the players are reluctant to push back and argue, right? They don't want to come off as like some baby in a room where there's no yelling fans and you're going to hear them. So it's been very enjoyable from that. And I'm with you. I think that is going to be a huge aspect of this season, and they're not going to feel the pressure this year. All right, damn. I'm going with Deshaun Watson. He's going to be happy, and specifically just because of week one. You just talked about it. I mean, week one is supposed to be on the road against the Super Bowl champs, the unveiling of the banner. Kansas City's already the loudest damn stadium we've ever, been in, certainly in that conversation. And then added to the fact that Deshaun Watson's left tackle, Laremy Tunsil, led the NFL in false starts last year with 12. The next closest one was at 7. So it's almost like a double whammy there. I could have picked Laremy Tunsil, too, because he'll probably be very happy that he doesn't have to deal with the crowd noise. But, hey, Deshaun Watson's got some new receivers. David Johnson's there, some new weapons. And not have to deal with the energy of Kansas City after a Super Bowl, and on a week one start of the NFL season. Man, what a gift that is for a starting quarterback.
Always a raucous setting the night that the team raises the banner. They celebrate a little harder. They're louder than they would be. And, yeah, it's a tough place to win, even on a regular night. But on the night that they celebrate their first championship in 50 years, it would have been virtually impossible. Now Deshaun Watson and company have a chance if there's only a limited capacity of fans there. All right, look, you could say that any quarterback is going to be happy about having no fans because the quarterback will be able to run his offense on the road without a silent count, without straining his vocal cords to try to communicate, without having his offensive linemen lose the benefit of that split second of the play starting before the defense realizes the play has started. There's one quarterback in particular, though, who benefits from it both at home and on the road because the Chargers never have a home game. The Chargers always have to hear the booing. They always have to hear the crowd for the other team. They always have to be conscious of operating their offense while there's noise. They're not going to shut up at the Chargers' old stadium or their new stadium, for that matter. It's not going to get any better in their new stadium. There's just going to be even more fans there who are rooting against the Chargers. So Tyrod Taylor, to me, is the most fortunate of all the quarterbacks, because quiet is something he's going to have, not just on the road, but at home. Every game of the year, he's going to be able to operate in peace, and it would have been the opposite of that if the Chargers were playing in full stadiums all year long.
No, it is interesting. You know, I would be interested to see what that Chargers crowd would look like, you know, because you're right. You know, the other stadium was overrun by the opposing team's fans. I don't think it would have been any different in this new stadium. I don't, because I think more people would actually be like, wait, we definitely want to go now. We get to go to LA and see this new stadium, to where the opposing team would, I think it would be the same effect. So you're right, Mike. I really think it's a great discussion anyways. I almost sometimes think with the no crowd stuff, is that a disadvantage almost for a guy like Drew Brees and Tom Brady, who, you know, separate themselves and the ability to handle crowd noise and be great and execute an offense with all the craziness that goes on? You know, to me, does that almost level the playing field? It's just something to watch out for that I think is kind
Listen, it takes that factor. Dealing with a hostile crowd on the road, dealing with a hostile crowd at home.
Yeah, it can happen.
Right? It's practice all the time now.
Right.
It's just practice. That's how it's going to feel for every game of the regular season, except those games that will have some fans. But even then, it's not going to be so many fans that it's going to make a difference. It's going to be so loud you can't hear yourself think. So, yeah, I think it's going to be a huge factor. And you're right. I think it's going to be an equalizer where quarterbacks who previously, and we've seen it with LeBron James, he seems a little bit out of sorts without fans there to feed off of.
Yeah.
There's going to be some quarterbacks who may be perfectly happy playing without fans there. All right, you're up.
All right, we're going to have a little fun with this one. I mean, like you said, quarterbacks, they'll be happy. You know, a lot of them will be with no crowd. Defensive ends, they certainly come to my mind too. You know, those home games, I'm going to pick Myles Garrett. One, because he arguably has the greatest first step in all of football. So now the fact that he's literally going to be able to hear the quarterback breathing, let alone the snap count, and really be able to hear all the inflection of the voice and get a telltale sign that way. But also with Myles Garrett, yeah, it's a great advantage for him on the field to get more sacks. But also, he's got to be really happy he doesn't got to go to Pittsburgh week 6 this year. I mean, you want to talk about the booze of booze this year. Woo! He would get torn up in Pittsburgh this year, going there, having to deal with that. That would have been a rabid fan base, and a rabid fan base that would have filtered over to the team too. They're still going to be pissed about it, Pittsburgh Steelers, but I think the fans can get the players more revved up to want to take, you know, shots at Myles Garrett and prove him like that he's a jerk too. So Myles Garrett, because of Pittsburgh and because he is one of the best pass rushers in football and has an amazing first step, he's going to be happy there's no crowd.
Hey, and you know, you touched on, I think, an excellent point that I hadn't previously thought of. Within the confines of a given game, it's going to be so much easier to crack that verbal code because you can hear it well.
Right.
And you can pick up the rhythm better. And you can really focus what you are hearing from the quarterback. So by the third or fourth quarter, or maybe by the second quarter, unless they're changing things up, and I think that's something coaches need to be conscious of.
You've got to change up
the inflection.
Right.
Change up the pattern verbally, or they're going to figure it out and they're going to be all over you. All right, next one for me, and this is practical. This is real. I'm not trying to make it political. I'm not trying to go down a rabbit hole that's going to cause us to have a long discussion. Anyone who kneels is going to be happy that fans aren't there. We saw it last week in Dallas, the first MLS game with fans present, Nashville and Dallas. The players kneeled and the fans booed, and one of the players reacted to that at the press conference after the game, and he got death threats after the fact. I mean, look, if fans aren't there, because even if it's split 50-50, as it seems to be, the 50 who don't like the kneeling are going to make it known, and they're going to boo, and it's going to be hostile, and it's going to be ugly. So anyone who chooses to exercise their First Amendment right to kneel is going to be happy to not have fans there this year, because if the fans are there, we know from experience they are going to let these guys have it, Chris.
Yeah, no, you're right about that. I didn't even think about that, Mike. That's a good pick. You're not going to have to deal with that negative criticism of somebody behind you on the bench now, you know, yelling crazy things because you didn't see the world the way they exactly saw it. Oh, gosh, how dare you?
All game long.
Yeah, all game
all
long.
All game long.
You're not an American. You're a horrible human being. Okay, right. And you just did 9 different un-American things, but that's okay. All right, so I'm going – it's people. I'm going with the San Francisco 49ers. If you want me to be more specific, I'll say Shanahan and Garoppolo, but hear me out. Hey, we know they got a bullseye on their back. They're a Super Bowl team, right? So everyone's always, oh, Super Bowl team's coming to town. We got to take them down to show where we're at as a team. But also, their schedule this year, it's the NFC East and the AFC East. It is certainly going to make life a little easier on those cross-country trips when you don't have to deal with a fan base on top of that, you know, in the elements. And one of those trips was supposed to be in New England with Jimmy Garoppolo. I'm sure he'll be glad because that would have been a crazy crowd, you know, and that Cam Newton versus Jimmy Garoppolo, or at least we think it would be Cam Newton. But to me, that's one that jumped out, and a nice little free pass for the 49ers with such a tough, you know, logistics schedule this year.
Trip to Seattle, trip to New Orleans, no fans there.
That's right. They got that too.
Any day of the week.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.